Looks like I've been here all day. I hope that.
So, Mr. Chairman, the only other item on the agenda is review funding options. Is that correct?
That's correct.
That I'm disqualified, but I think I mentioned last time that serving on the board of the Citizens Bank in Forsyth County, I am absolutely disqualified from that discussion. Plus, I've got a jury waiting to get started back, so I will take my leave. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Your Honor.
All right, we're back to item two, review funding options. Additional discussion.
Okay, one more thing. Sure. Good question the mayor brought up about interest rates and bank loans. I'll give you a little bit of what I've seen, a little bit market wise, a little bit of what the banks have talked about. Remember, a fixed rate is going to be for 5 years, it's going to be at least at 2.6%. It could be higher. We're going to go right and say, give us a quote for a 5 year loan. Variable rates are lower, and they're probably going to be in the range of 2.1%, 2.2%, somewhere around there, from what we're starting to see from some of the banks. Think about variable rates, and they may stay flat for right now in the market. It's at least 2 years, but you know, world economy, I'm not going to make any bets in interest rates myself. The fact that they're variable is just there's a component of risk to that and cost, especially since the repayment's going to be a little bit more back-end loaded. So that gives you a little bit more of an idea of interest rate cost with banks. Variable rate right now, you can probably get low twos, 2.2%. Fixed rate for 5 years is going to be above, I think 2.6 is probably pretty close to where I think the market is now. The only other thing to consider there, and we could also do a variable rate bond, and that would be much lower than 1.3% now.
Too much risk.
Change.
Too much risk.
And too much risk. And the thing where I can see that risk, others are sensitive to it. In our discussion with the rating agencies, particularly S&P, they were really drilling us on questions about, we only have one variable rate bond out there right now. And when they were doing our rating, our double A-plus rating, I think we might get AAA, that made them very nervous to have a variable rate issue out there, and under what scenarios could it be called in and so on. So, you know, variable rate is tempting because it's so low, but I think fixed rates are likewise as low as you're ever going to see them pretty much right now. So that just add a little bit to the discussion of interest rates and risk.
Dave, one question. When do you think we'll know if we need a 30 or 40 or 50 million? I mean, what's our time frame on this?
I think as we have an idea when we'll have an architect on board, because then they're going to start doing work and we're going to start needing cash. That will give us a much better idea of maybe which month toward the end of this year. I think it's going to be before January 1, we'll probably need some funding, but I'm not sure how close to July at this point. But, and there's one other thing involved here with the county. Commissioner Levent was pointing out that may affect the amount is what about other projects and road projects and, you know, engineering and so on. So the commission maybe have some concern there, and that could affect the amount we borrow for the jail and courthouse, but it affects how much of the other dollars are available for other projects. So
they do 1, 2, 3, 4 streets per neighborhood around the whole county every year just to try to keep up with the road improvements. And I hate to see them shut those down for 3 or 4 years and then us try to catch up. It'd be very hard on them.
On the bond, I favor the banks, but this is the reason. If you do a bond and say you got to have $40 million, you do a bond for $40 million. You start paying interest on it.
Right.
On the banks, you pay interest on what you borrow right at that particular day. If you borrow $1 million, if you have a pay request, I think you can expedite the project a lot faster by doing it through local banks and have one bank who is going to work with all the local banks, and they got their pool of ever how much money the board votes they need down the road, whether it's 30 million, 40 million, or whatever, which I think it'll be somewhat less probably because another year the SPLOST 7 revenue is going to be coming in, and as Chairman alluded to, you've got maybe 8% over what it was last year right now. And you say it could be as much as 4% throughout the year. So if we're going to be taking in the revenue, we don't want to be. I think logic would be that you use that revenue to pay down the loan, and you won't be penalized due to the fact this local banks rather than a bonding company. So that's my theory.
I would agree with you, ma'am. In addition to that, you want to borrow right away, so you'll save interest on it.
but and I did take that timing into consideration of this 2 million versus 2.5 million interest. I did take into consideration the bond issue all at once and drawing the banks down. So even though this bank rate of 2.6% is twice 1.3%, you notice the cost is not twice as much because I've calculated in only paying interest on when we draw the money.
What kind of time frame do we need to deal with banks or bond companies? Do we need to start 2 months before we need the money, or 30 days, or? That could be critical.
I mean, the bank is ready. Once they do their credit checks, and some of them banks have already been working on this, and they're virtually ready to go themselves. The time constraint there is getting all the legal documents in place. Because the lawyers still have to work on the documents, the bank's lawyers, our counsel, it'll be just as binding as a bond issue. I mean, it'll be that secure for the banks as a bond issue, as a bondholder would be. So as fast as the attorneys can get all the paperwork, so I'm thinking probably within 30 days would be my guess on that.
If we use the $40 million, if we bond it, if we went for a bond for $40 million, and then at the end of the day, we only use $30 million, that additional $10 million could not be redirected to other projects because of the, as I understand, the wording in the referendum is still going to be locked in correct. To this project.
Correct.
Whether we needed it or not.
Well, as money comes in, you don't have to throw it in the jail courthouse and you can use that for the other projects.
That is another point. You're right. I mean, that with that cushion, then other monies from the SPLOST could be redirected to the other projects.
Mm-hmm. And all of our other departments won't be able to keep up with their duties and not get so far behind.
Right.
If we borrow $40 million, these projects, 2 projects are $100 million, so they will be first dollar. We will, I think, whatever we borrow is going to be considered going to the jail courthouse.
Sure.
It just leaves some of the sales tax collections available for them.
And then on the other hand, these bond funding options and the bank loan options are really moving targets, because under the bond funding, you've got options there that don't compare with banks, because the banks may be paid back quicker than you'll pay the bonds back.
Well, only up to $14 to $15 million per year, because a referendum restricts our ability to do that.
But say for instance you wanted to do that in the bank, you could do that where you're not legally bound to do that with bonds.
Right. You have more flexibility with the bank loan as to how much you borrow and when you pay it back. Right. Bonds are fixed issue, although you can have call provision in a bond, which means you can pay it back earlier. But if you have a call provision, that pushes the interest rate up.
It's a penalty.
There's a premium for that.
Is this some decision we need to make today?
I think I was just reporting based on the committee's interest.
Yeah, I don't really think that we can make a decision unless
right.
We have a more
uncertainty.
There's still this uncertainty about the exact amount of money we're talking about here, but understanding what our options are.
What I convey to the banks is we're trying to be in a position where that's where we want to go. The board commission wants to say that we're ready to go with them.
So sure.
And then we have selected a group that's interested.
Well, to save you time and energy, does this board need to vote whether we want to go bonds or banks? I don't know that the board couldn't go ahead and decide to say.
I wouldn't recommend that at this point, since the cost could vary on which vehicle you use, depending on how much and when. I don't know if we're to that point. I wouldn't recommend making that decision at this point myself.
Would it make sense to get the program manager on board, let him and his staff work on cash flow analysis for us, and then we'll know what that amount might be? At that point, we could reconvene, talk about this issue again, and then make a recommendation to the Board of Commissioners.
We've only been working off of one schedule. That schedule of how fast or how slow it takes to build these things can shift dramatically. There goes millions of dollars in a construction schedule. So
and
that's
help, important. Help this group with this. If in fact we follow that timeline, but we need some funding on the front end to pay for the project manager and maybe even the architect, we've got funding elsewhere that we can use until we cure this funding for the project.
Yes, and we fronted some money to buy the properties and so on. So.
What kind of time frame would that be? 2-3 months out, so if you're thinking about revisit this again?
I don't know if we get the program manager.
But I'm saying, what do you anticipate?
The RFP closes on the 24th of May.
Right.
And so after that, it's the selection process. And it really, I hate to put a timeline on the selection process, it really depends on how many we get.
Right.
I have had 36 firms pick up, and I took out the ones that I know aren't firms. 36 firms have picked up the proposal. So I'm not going to get 36 responses, I don't believe.
3 to 4 months, 2 to 4 months?
Once we get them, we have our initial kickoff meeting on the 30th of this month of May. I would say at least a 4-week period before we take it to this board and then to the Board of Commissioners for review.
Okay, then they have to have time to put their numbers together.
Exactly.
So you could be 4 months out.
Yeah, they'll need some time to get on board and look at the program.
Very good. Just trying to get an idea.
Right.
Sure.
Any other discussion on that item? No action on that item at this time. Dave, anything else?
No, we'll keep monitoring market conditions and we'll get the ideas in from the banks as what kind of vehicles they think they could offer.
Thank you. That is the last item on the agenda, unless there's further discussion. One thing I do want to mention is, even though we didn't send out invitations, I think the first time around we had mentioned you are more than welcome to bring your support staff, and that's just an open invitation. If you've got support staff that you would like to have at these meetings, you're welcome to invite them on your own. We don't want to assume that to invite them that you want us to invite them, or we assume who those folks are. So any support staff you'd like to have in these meetings, please invite them.
Commissioners don't get support staff, sir. I think you're talking to me.
I am your support staff.
He's here.
Do I hear any other business before the board? Or this team?